glucose is partially oxidized to produce the two pyruvic acid molecules. So this is the metabolic pathway included in respiration. Here it composed of 10 reactions. So these reactions are involved by different respiratory enzymes. It means number of respiratory enzymes are involved in glycolysis reaction. In this reaction, the glucose is being turned into two pyruvic acid molecules, that is partial oxidation of glucose is carried out here. So what are the reactions are carried out? We see. So the glycolysis is started with glucose molecule. So the glucose is hexose sugar. It consisting of how many carbons? 6 carbons. Hence you write as 6C, hexose sugar. So the glucose is first phosphorylated. So the glucose phosphorylated into glucose 6-phosphate. So here the ATP is required. So it is ATP dependent reaction. The ATP molecule, adenosine triphosphate molecule, is turned into ADP plus PI. During this reaction, the energy is released. The released energy is utilized in the conversion of glucose into glucose 6-phosphate. This reaction is said as phosphorylation. So the phosphorylation reaction is carried out by the help of the enzyme, that is hexokinase. Sometimes we said as glucokinase. What is the kinase activity? Kinase can transfer the phosphate group from one substrate to another. So here the inorganic phosphate is released from ATP. So the released inorganic phosphate is bind with the glucose. Then the glucose is turned into glucose 6-phosphate. It means the phosphorylation reaction carried out here. What is the next reaction? The next reaction is isomerization. Isomerization means making of isomer. So glucose is isomer to fructose. So here fructose 6-phosphate is produced during isomerization reaction. Here the enzyme is isomerase enzyme. What type of isomerase? That is hexoisomerase enzyme. So this hexoisomerase enzyme can mediate the reaction of glucose 6-phosphate to fructose 6-phosphate formation. And next reaction also second phosphorylation. Again here the ATP is required. So adenosine triphosphate is converted into adenosine diphosphate and inorganic phosphate. Here again the mediated enzyme is hexokinase enzyme. Okay, and here that resulted to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. Then this fructose 1,6-bisphosphate split as triose molecules.
You see here, glucose is hexose sugar, fructose also hexose sugar. So the fructose is having the 6 carbons, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate also having the 6 carbon. The 6 carbon consisting fructose 1,6-bisphosphate can split as 2 triose molecules. Triose molecules means, tri means how many? 3. Triose molecule means 3 carbon compounds, 3 carbon consisting sugar. Okay,
what they are? PGAL, phosphoglyceraldehyde. DHAP, dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So these two are considered as triose phosphates.
PGAL, DHAP. So this reaction is mediated by the enzyme aldolase, and this reaction is called as split reaction. So cleavage, the cleavage is going on here. So due to the cleavage of fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, phosphoglyceraldehyde triose phosphate, dihydroxyacetone phosphate, these two are produced. Here, the aldolase enzyme can have the capability of catalytic reaction as well as anabolic synthetic reaction. Synthetic reaction means when PGAL or DHAP, these two are combined to produce fructose 1,6-bisphosphate in the presence of aldolase enzyme. It means vice versa reactions are taken. Fructose 1-bisphosphate to PGAL plus DHAP and PGAL plus DHAP to fructose bisphosphate. 1,6-bisphosphate are produced in the presence of aldolase enzyme. Here, till energy requirement is stopped. You see here, the required energy is in the form of 2 ATPs only for glycolysis metabolic pathway. So how many ATPs? 1 ATP and 2 ATPs. 1 ATP is utilized in the first reaction and the second ATP is utilized in the third reaction of glycolysis. Totally, how many ATPs are required for the initiation of glucose or completion of glucose means, completion of glycolysis means, totally 2 ATPs are required. Then it go for the next. So you see here, how many carbon molecules are involved here? Only one carbon molecule is involved. The carbon molecule is hexose sugar. The hexose sugar is converted into triose sugars. The triose sugars are produced. It means here two cycles are carried out because these two are isomers. These two are isomers. So PGAL to DHAP can produce, DHAP to PGAL can produce. So both are isomers. So for their isomerization, there is a need of enzyme that is called triose isomerase. So in the presence of the triose isomerase, the PGAL is converted into DHAP and DHAP converted into PGAL. It means vice versa reactions are carried out here. Okay, then one of the triose phosphate involved in the continues the glycolysis cycle.